2K Sports and the Korn Ferry Tour are delighted to welcome you to today's event. Today's coverage of the Kelly Classic is set to kick off. Pleased you could join us for this second round action. I'm Luke Elvey alongside Rich Beaman. This player starts their round in the lead. How should they approach today?
Well, they've got the lead, and there is a significant chasing pack, so they can't get too wrapped up in what's going on behind them. They've got to kind of keep their nose out front. They got to keep pushing along and play the golf course. Don't think about who's chasing you down. Just think about playing the golf course. But if you do find themselves falling back a little bit, then they need to go ahead and start making a little bit different push, maybe come up with a different game plan. But right now, out in front, they just kind of have to play the golf course right now and keep that in their sights.
It's all set up to be a beauty. Let's see how it unfolds. Oh, I could watch that swing all day. That's beautiful. And he's down there.
He's looking at perhaps 175, I'd say.
Okay, let's get those two important things back, timing and tempo. That approach didn't seem to fit their eye.
Missing it short there, they will definitely be upset.
This would be a momentum saver here, getting this up and down.
Just missed the hole. Just a tiny putt is all that remains. So it'll be a par to start their round.
Very nice par indeed. Very solid hole play.
And now that finds him in first place. Love the long holes. Welcome to the par five. And after a par at the last, a chance to perhaps signal some intent.
Lovely, lovely rhythm.
Second shot on the second. And here we are with the third shot.
Great shot. A chance for a birdie if this goes down.
Surely it's going to.
Fair effort, that. Good birdie. Currently 9 under for the event. Let's see what happens here at the third hole.
That'll work. That's fine.
And Henny, what kind of a shot are they facing this time?
This is looking around 115 yards out.
Okay, not the best result, but a chance to get up and down.
Oh, a little shorty Baker on that action there.
If he makes this, he'll save his par. Right by the hole. Okay, Henny, what's he looking at with this putt?
They've just got to focus on hitting the back of the cup, guys. This is up the hill, bit of extra juice needed.
Oh, so close. I don't want to drop any more shots. Let's make this for double. He's currently tied for second.
Moving down the leaderboard, Luke, never a good thing.
And they'll have to compose themselves now with this tee shot after a double bogey at the last.
Off the tee, your eyes look down the left-hand side and see two massive bunkers and obviously the water. So anything right of that is just fine. If you find the fairway, second shot is downhill just a little bit to a long, narrow green that has got bunkers down the right-hand side. Distance control with that second shot is absolutely imperative if they want to have a good look at birdie.
This shot coming from around the 150-yard marker. Just one shot back now. Looks to have opted for the 8-iron.
Club up. I like this play.
Wow, what a shot.
Gotta like their chances from there.
This putt right on 10 feet. A good one to make.
This is their look at birdie. Now that's how you roll the rock.
Oh, that's a ripper. Step aside, everyone else. Now number one. The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. Here we are at the fifth hole. That swing looked a little jerky from where I'm sitting. That was never really a comfortable shot for them, was it?
Not taking enough club to get it there.
Of class holds it from the sand. Well, that's certainly worth another look.
Now this is how you play a bunker shot.
Now leading by one shot. And the player steps up to this short par four.
Standing on this par four and leading. What's the strategy? What's going on through their mind? Attack it or lay back?
That reminded me of the Big Easy. Silky smooth. Second shot here on the sixth. This putt to get to 10 under par. So close, but an easy par. Just a short putt remaining here. Now at minus nine for the tournament. Teeing off here at the seventh. Just let that shot be water off a duck's back. Henny, how bad is this lie?
This is what bad luck looks like. Just off the fairway, but sitting really down.
Heading towards the rough, this one. Sitting at 9 under par, currently tied for first place. And choosing the 8-iron here.
Yep, solid connection. This is looking good.
That's not the outcome they were after.
Now from that lie, missing the green was always an option.
This putt of about 7 feet to the hole.
An important par save.
Just didn't drop. And this one is for bogey.
In she goes. Let's head to the next.
Just one off the lead after that hole. Just a couple to play here on the opening nine. Here's the tee shot at the eighth. Looks like they've got the 5-wood. Didn't quite have the right stuff there.
Well, definitely the wind had to have gotten a hold of that one.
From the sand, looking to get up and down. Okay, step one complete, out of the bunker. Now let's go make a putt.
And if this can go down, he'll save par.
Oh, that was such a good stroke.
And in she goes. That's a good save.
And that is a nice up and down out of the greenside bunker for the par.
And staying right where they were in today's rankings after that. Teeing off now on the ninth hole. And they found themselves in the first cut. Opting for the 3-wood. Didn't quite strike that as cleanly as they would have hoped.
That's been the story of the day, isn't it, Luke? Has missed a lot of greens, and you can't afford to do that on this golf course.
What are we looking at for this putt, Henny?
Setting up this putt 28 feet from the cup. Nice little par putt here.
It was on a good line. This next putt is for bogey. He's currently tied for sixth. Teeing off now on the 10th hole.
Coming off of a bogey, looking for a birdie. No harm, no foul there with that shot.
Nicely done. Getting ready to play their third. Four strokes off the lead. Still a fair way away from the hole here. Time to make a long putt. That'll sting a bit.
It's a lot slower going up the hill than what this player read.
This is a par putt. That's well held. Trailing by four strokes. Teeing off now at the 11th hole.
Just a slight bit uphill off the tee shot. Find a spot at that far bunker, Luke, that you want to aim at and go ahead and turn it loose. From there, second shot goes over a nice little meandering stream that wanders throughout the golf course to a green, clover-like in appearance, but I gotta say, this is really one of the coolest holes on the golf course. I love it.
Well, this is not a good outcome. Buried in the deep stuff. Seems to have chosen the three wood. Keep your fingers crossed for a bounce to the right. Sitting at 7 under, currently tied for 6th. The dreaded shove always hurts on the greens.
What's in front of them, Henny, with this putt?
This one will run uphill.
Come on, ball, don't deny him.
And down she goes from outside the range. Ooh, that was a touch of class. I wouldn't mind seeing that again.
Now this is how you putt. Take another look at this.
Current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. Let's head to the 12th hole. And he's hit that inside the range. Let's move one step closer to the lead here. This putt for a share of 4.
I can't believe this. Is this going to go in?
Not sure if they understood the lie of the land there, Rich. This putt just 5 feet away from the hole.
This is what they have left for a par.
And this one will be for bogey.
Unfortunately, moving down the leaderboard, that's not the direction to be heading. Let's see what happens here on the 13th hole, shall we?
Well, thankfully, it's slightly downhill off the tee, but yes, avoid those bunkers down the right-hand side and, of course, that meandering brook that is a feature of this golf course. Big hitters can actually take it over everything down that right-hand side, but that's for the brave few. Second shot, downhill slightly to a massive green. Just some big bunkers on the left-hand side, but plenty of bailout room over to the right.
Second shot here on the 13th hole. Going with the 5 wood. That wasn't their best approach, Beamer.
Gotta believe the wind affected the golf ball there.
Oh, these are good for the momentum, these ones, right on 8 feet. Hey, that's a chance. And in it goes for the par. Currently 6 under for the event. We've arrived at a par 4 hole.
Really hoping they play this one aggressively.
Not bad. Time for the second shot at the 14th. Yep, give yourself a pat on the back. This putt to get to 7 under the card. Looking really good, this one. And that's their 4th birdie of the day. And with that, he'll move to 7 under. Incredible. Well, that was a positive hole. A little shift up the leaderboard. Well played. I'm pretty sure this player will be buoyed by that birdie back at the last. Let's see if they can deliver another one. Wonderfully played. And this shot from about 150 yards out.
Puff of breeze moving this golf ball left to right.
Choosing the 9-iron here.
I don't know if they meant to do that.
Not the result they were after there.
Oh, look at that. The wind just wreaking havoc with that shot. Disappointing.
Oh, I thought that one was going in. This putt is about 19 feet in distance. Get in. Oh, that's frustrating. No, that's too bad. This is a bogey putt coming up. Trailing by 5 shots after that hole. Trying to shake off the bogey on the last hole as they step onto this tee. opting for the 9-iron. This one's heading left, I think. No green in reg, but a chance to save their par. Oh, just missed. 3 feet to go here to the hole.
This is what they have left for par.
And that puddle drop. Well done. The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. This hole is a par four, and it's a pretty lengthy one at that. Well, on the tee now, coming off for par. Chance to pipe one up the middle. Good looking shot, this. Do you like the view from where you're standing, Henny?
Our wind's just gonna knock the ball down. It's straight at the back.
Going with the pitching wedge here. Well, that's well judged. Hole high, right inside the range. What are we looking at for this putt, Henny?
Yeah, he's staring down about 12 feet.
Ouch, that hurts. An opportunity to make their par. Well, it was a wonderful approach shot, wasn't it? But unfortunately having to settle for par. No movement up or down on the leaderboard for this player. Well, it's come down to this, the final hole. Welcome to the 18th. Oh, that's piped. That's heading down the runway. That's a bit out of shape. And here we are with the third shot.
Pro tip, when it's breezy, swing easy. You're welcome.
I like that strike. This one's heading well towards the green. Time now for the fourth shot. A bit long on that one. 6 feet remaining to the cup. This one started out on a good line. Just couldn't quite get it to drop. And just a little bit of clean-up work remaining on this hole. That always leaves a bit of a disappointing taste in the mouth. A little bogey tap in to finish. So, 2 rounds in the books, Rich. Not a bad little day's work, I think.
No, and only 2 more to go. Looking forward to seeing what happens over the final 36.
Well, another great day of action here at 2K Sports. On behalf of Rich Beam, the entire hardworking folks and team here, I'm Luke Elvey. We look forward to your company next time.